The official reasoning on how Juice WRLD passed away is finally released, and in this video, I will be covering it all for you guys today. Are you interested in winning any of the items on the screen? If so, leave a like on this video right now, subscribe to the channel, and watch the full video to find the hidden message that you must comment to enter. Good luck. Now, everyone has definitely heard the sad news by now that Juice WRLD has passed away December 8th, 2019, due to a seizure that he had in a Chicago airport. Now, Juice WRLD was literally one of the fastest growing music artists that we have ever had in the music industry in a very long time. After the release of Goodbye and Good Riddance, Juice WRLD became a literal overnight sensation. A big part of it, however, did come from his two songs, Lucid Dreams and All Girls Are the Same, but nonetheless, I actually found all of his songs to be amazing and perfectly crafted. Now, I am going to be going into full detail right now about the truth behind Juice WRLD's passing, so make sure you guys keep on watching this video all the way until the end if you guys are a Juice WRLD fan, because these are things that you're going to need to know. Now, on December 8th, 2019, Juice WRLD was taking a private jet out of his hometown with his full team and a couple security members. While in the air, it was reported to Juice WRLD that his plane was being followed by law enforcement and that he was actually being scouted on the airplane monitor things in every airport, so then police would know exactly when his jet landed. Now, while they were in the air, one of Juice WRLD's team members were informed about the law enforcement, following his private jet and everything, and then once Juice WRLD heard the news, he allegedly started freaking out on the plane, didn't know what to do. His girlfriend was trying to calm him down and everything, but he did not know what to do. Now, this is when Juice WRLD started freaking out, because on his private jet, he had multiple illegal things on it that he definitely should never have had with him on this plane. On Juice WRLD's private jet, he had 70 pounds of narcotics, 2 firearms, high-capacity ammunition magazines, and narcotic pills as well. Now, these are things that you should never have on an airplane. Does not matter if you're renting a private jet or anything, there are rules that you have to follow, and Juice WRLD should have never had these on his plane. Now, currently right now, it was reported by multiple news outlets that the real reasoning on why the law enforcement believe Juice WRLD has his seizure at the Chicago airport was because when Juice WRLD found out that his flight was being followed by law enforcement, he took all of the narcotic pills, so then the law would not charge him for having them on him as well as everything else that was on the plane. Now, yes, the plane was rented in his name, so that actually does mean that everything that was on the plane, with all of these illegal things that were on it, Juice WRLD would be taking literally all of the blame for it. Does not matter if one of his teammates said, oh, all that stuff is mine, Juice WRLD had nothing to do with it. It literally does not matter, because Juice WRLD's name is on the receipt for who rented the plane. So everything is in his name. So because his name was on everything, that means that Juice WRLD then would be getting locked up for everything that was on the plane, because yes, everything that was on the plane with him is a crime. Now, it actually still is, unsure of the exact time that Juice WRLD would have gotten locked up for something like this, but some law students did write an article on it with Juice WRLD's situation, and for all of these illegal things that he had on his private jet, and because he does have priors, he actually would have been facing a minimum of 20 years locked up for this crime. And yes, this was technically a crime, believe it or not, because even with the firearms that were on the plane at the time, one of them actually was licensed, but even though it was licensed, it still doesn't mean that you're allowed to take it on a plane, which one of his team members still did without even caring. He still brought it on the plane for some reason. He most likely already knows the rules because he is a licensed holder, but he still did it anyway, which makes absolutely no sense to me. Now, currently, the law thinks that Juice WRLD took all of these narcotic pills, so then he actually would get less charges on his record when he was caught at the airport. But sadly, it seems as if he took too many at the time, and then he got real nervous at the airport and everything and security, and then that is what led to his seizure inside of the airport. This is what sources are saying online right now, what a lot of news articles are saying right now. It's actually kind of crazy to think, why Juice WRLD would even ever think of bringing things like this on a private jet. It's actually happened to him before a couple months ago. He was being followed by law enforcement, so it's not like it was new to Juice WRLD. This actually happened to him before. And, you know, he didn't really get hit too hard before because he only had little things on him at the time. But at this time now, he had way too much things on him. And it was kind of crazy. And I'm really upset that this all even happened. I really wish that Juice WRLD, you know, played this situation smarter. I mean, why do you need to be bringing 70 pounds of narcotics on a private jet? I don't really understand, but it is still very sad. We did lose a legend in the music industry, and I'm actually very upset about it. But anyways, guys, I am going to be ending the video here. If you guys did enjoy, please leave a like on it and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. It has been District Trending, and I'm out. Peace.